bring it back. From the End of Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mixmaster G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps again. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. This stream is free for everybody to throw whatever question you have in the chat. And the subject today is going to be the little bit controversial subject of audio streaming services for DJs. So that is what we are going to dig about. But before we start, let me introduce myself to you for those who don't know me. My name is Mixmaster G. I'm a 54-year-old dude from the Netherlands. You can hear it by the accent. I am a retired DJ, which means I'm no longer an active DJ. I had my first residency at the age of 15, so I have a lot of years of experience under the belt, and I want to share that experience with you guys so you can have a benefit from it. The news today broke that Denon DJ just released Engine Prime 1.6, and Engine Prime 1.6 is the long-awaited final release version of 1.6, the public beta. I've played a little bit with it. It seems to be as stable as the public beta was. I've been on the public beta since October and everything was fine with it. So for those who are a little bit afraid to update their Denon gear, do it. 1.6 is fine. And a lot of the stuff I'm going to talk about in this particular Ask Me Anything is about audio streaming services, and you need Engine Prime 1.6 and the 1.6 firmware for that. Let me do a shout out to Michael. Hi Michael. Yes, I have decided that my old trap remix of the Red Panther theme is going to be my opening theme, because some people said you need to have audio while you are starting a stream. So I just brought in a tune that I know will not be taken down because I did made it. Something else. Audio streaming for DJs, and this is controversial because I am of the age that audio tracks really costed money. If I remember, the first single, that's a 45, we call that a single in the Netherlands, the first 45 I bought was at that time 5 guilder. And 5 guilder was the equivalent for a guy like me of working a complete afternoon your ass off before you had 5 guilders. That gives you a little bit of an idea about the value of audio tracks back then. And that also made that that it was very important that you save your money for your audio tracks. So audio tracks costed money, real money in the past. With all the audio streaming services of today, a lot of people forget the value of audio tracks. You just use your Spotify or whatever and you turn it on, you've got everything there. So tracks are kind of worthless. You have a 10 euro subscription to Spotify, you've got every track in the world. Back in the days when I started out, that wasn't the case. I remember that at certain clubs I played, I had an understanding that I took less of a salary, but in addition, I wanted to have access to the booth and their record collection in the afternoon so I could make my remixes there. That was because I couldn't buy all those records myself. I didn't simply have the money for that. So back in the days, both hardware equipment, but audio tracks as well were a real problem or were real pricey or were a real thing to have. And of course, I've been there. I've been there when we went from reel-to-reel tapes to compact cassette to dead tapes to digital compact cassettes. Do you remember those ones? Those were by Philips. Those were after the dead digital compact cassettes. You could put your old real compact cassette in it and it was compatible with that as well. I've been there all. I've been there when vinyl went to CDs and the first CD players didn't have any pitch controls and all the DJs were screaming and kicking. I'm never going to use a CD in my life because it doesn't have pitch control and you don't have any control about what was going on. That was true with the first generation of CD players, way before we were talking CDJs and stuff like that. Then I was there when the MP3s came, when the Napsters of this world came with the illegal downloads, when iTunes opened for the first time. So I've seen it all. And my understanding right now is that audio streaming for DJs will be the next big thing. I hear a lot of people saying, yeah, but Mixmaster G, you need to have a reliable internet connection at your location where you're playing. That will be there. Don't worry, that will be there. I'm convinced that once we are behind COVID, every DJ booth in the world will have a wired internet connection, simply because every DJ in the world is right now used to being streaming their sets and they want to continue to stream their sets. So even if the clubs are open, they will stream their sets, and for streaming their sets they need a reliable internet connection. So the internet connection will be in the booth. Now, in case the internet connection is not in the booth, next year 5G will be operational for a biggest part in the globe, which means you have very fast internet just in your pocket. You don't even need a wide internet anymore. So internet availability cannot be a reason not to use audio services or audio streaming services. Now, what can be a reason? One of the reasons can be those things can go down. During the past months, as some of you might know, I've been developing an app called the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming. Basically, what the DJ Conversion Utility does for real audio tracks from audio tracks you have bought, the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming does for audio tracks from audio streaming service. And during those developments, I had at least 2 instances that Tidal went down. One instance was basically that the Denon DJ gear, that is this stuff, let me say, oh, so many cameras, that stuff, that was not capable of reaching any Tidal service. They just gave an error while the Tidal services in Serato, etc. were working fine. Another example is that on a given Tuesday morning, the Tidal service was entirely down. At least in the western part of Europe, if the Twitch messages were any measure there. So this stuff can go down, and if it goes down, have a backup plan. So in general, how do I see all those audio streaming services? First of all, I am going to First of all, I'm going to talk about three streaming services. The first streaming service I'm going to talk about is Tidal. The second one will be Beatport Link. And the third one will be BeatSource Link. And those things, those are the three services I want to address. And before we start about how to work with them, I first want to talk with you guys about what the difference is between those three. And this is my personal opinion. So what I'm going to tell you is not necessarily what they think it is. No, it is my personal opinion. And that means that the things I say are just mine. Tidal in general is much like Spotify. Audio quality on Tidal is good. The selection is pretty big. So there is a lot of stuff there. Hold on, folks. Robert, I'm happy to address your problem with the Rekordbox Q and Key tool, but this stream is going to be from now till the next 45 minutes about audio streaming services. So please either email me or Facebook message me and I will get into your problem. Or otherwise wait at least 45 minutes so I've got the time to read the entire story you are copy and pasting right now in the chat box, because this is going to be all about streaming services. First of all, Tidal, which is much like Spotify, which means it has all your commercial tracks there. It has all your top 40 tracks and stuff like that in it. I see Tidal as the ideal partner for wedding DJs and mobile DJs. Those DJs who have a very fast collection of themselves, but get very odd requests then address them. Because you can download them from Tidal. Then the next step is BeatSource, or actually BeatSource Link. And BeatSource Link is a cooperation of DJ City, and we all know DJ City because that's Chris Mojax's club. And DJ City is a record pool, which means they have special remixes, special versions, special edits of records or tracks. And that cooperation, Beatport on one hand and DJ City on the other hand, together are an ideal marriage if you are a club DJ and you want to have some special edits, some special song, something. We all know Lean On by Major Lazer. They've got like six different versions of Lean On. So all those tracks everybody knows and loves, but in different versions. Then BeatSource is your streaming service. And finally, of course, there is Beatport Link, which is the streaming service of the famous Beatport. I consider that for the genre DJs. If you are a trance DJ, a drum and bass DJ, then you need Beatport access. Just in case you want to have a tune, both Beatport and BeatSource all have curated playlists. That means that they've got DJs actively curating their playlists and putting their best tracks in it. So let's say you want to spin like Little John. Little John has a playlist on BeatSource Link, and you can subscribe to that playlist and use the tracks from that playlist in your own set. So that is the big difference. So Tidal, wedding DJs, mobile DJs, BeatSource Link, club DJs who want to have a little spicy tracks in it, and Beatport if you are a genre specific DJ. Now, if you are a starting DJ, if you are beginning from scratch and you don't have anything at all, BeatSource Link would be my recommendation to you. The top 40 tracks are readily available on many platforms. You can buy them from Apple Music, you can get them on many things. So Tidal, I would skip there because Tidal is, well, what you basically can buy about what you like. But BeatSource Link will give you those extra edits, for instance, of those disco tunes that have grids that are all over the place or don't have a proper intro or outro beat. That kind of stuff you can find on BeatSource Link. So for those DJs, the beginning DJs, I think BeatSource Link is by far your best thing to do. Then, the next thing that is important, I made some notes, so let me look in my notes what is important. The good thing is all those audio streaming services have trial versions. You can subscribe to them for like 30 days and that won't cost you a dime. That is completely free to try. So that gives you an indication about what can I expect from that particular audio streaming service, what kind of what do they have in the catalog, and then if it is for you, you can subscribe indefinitely to them. Let me show you how I do that myself, and let me go to my other screen. Here we are. Because it is very, very, hold on. There I am. This is what I want to show you guys. Setting up those trial accounts is pretty straightforward. One tip from me is use your PayPal account, if you have a PayPal account, to pay for them. Why? Because especially in Beatport link and in BeatSource link, finding the cancel button is a little bit of a gamble. You have to search very far and it is very hard to find it. If you want to be sure that your subscription is canceled before it is going into a paid subscription, just use PayPal, and you can in PayPal have this list of automated payments you have set ready or have approved, pre-approved payments. Just take BeatSource and BeatPort link from it as long as you are in the trial period. And if you like it, of course, and allow it to have your payment. So that is your quickest way to do this. Then the next thing, and this is important, folks, because the catalogs of Tidal, BeatPort and BeatSource are so fast, so big, it is easy to get lost in those catalogs. It's easy to not find your track, and there are duplicate tracks in those services. So for instance, if you take the Lean On track by Major Lazer again, there is an album version there, there is a single version there, there is a release from Japan there, I don't know. There are a gazillion different releases of that track in the service. And if you just do a search on that track, you never know what is going to come up. The track will sound the same, the track will sound fine, but in some instances the cues you set previously will not be in that track, in other instances they will be. So my suggestion to everybody who is considering using audio services, make playlists in the audio service. That guarantees you that in all the different software you use, Serato, Rekordbox, the Denon Prime Gear, I will show that all in a moment, that on all those platforms, your playlists are the same. Much like using iTunes as your integrated collection manager, what I always recommend, so you have the same playlists throughout all the various DJ software. You can do exactly the same with audio streaming service by making your own playlists. And that is the first thing I want to show you guys, how you make your own playlists within the audio service. On Tidal, it is pretty straightforward. So let's go to my Tidal account. There we are. Let's go to the Tidal account and let me show you how that stuff works. Here we are on Tidal. Let's log in. And I'm using what I call a burner account for this kind of stuff, folks. So yeah, so you might see what the name of the account is. I really couldn't care less. It's a burner account. And I think I'm even on the wrong burner account here. So let me double check that off screen for you, which burner account I'm here, because I thought I just did empty them all and I see some playlists here. So I need to see what I'm on. Log out and let's log in again. That's one. That's two. We are logged in. Oh, those are still there. All right. At the left column right there, you see playlist, create playlist, etc. And we can create a new playlist. Let's call it the AMA playlist in Tidal. Why not? And as soon as we have the AMA playlist in Tidal created, let's close that one out, we can add tracks to it. And you can just do it by going to one of the created playlists. Let's say we want a Tiesto track there. Why not? Because who doesn't love Tiesto? There we are with Tiesto. And Let's see where it is, right there. And then we should be able to add it to the playlist, and that should be right here. Add to playlist, and then to the AMA playlist in Tidal. So now I added one track. Let me add some other stuff, like why not? Something went wrong. Question is always what went wrong, because it doesn't tell you. Something went wrong indefinitely. That's not good. Are now four tracks in that playlist. Why are the four tracks? Oh, it is the complete album I added. All right, we've got four tracks in the Test AMA playlist, which are all Tiesto tracks, obviously. And they are all coming from the Tiesto, the business album, which, oh no, it has one in it. And then these are recommended songs. I don't need recommendations. I just want to browse through the tracks. And I want to find Hypnotized by Biggie Small. And then something went wrong. Looks like Tidal is not working with me today. Let's look into Explorer. Why not? Something keeps going wrong now. Should go fine. Why not? Ah, it keeps going wrong. Some guys must love to see this, that even on Tidal, things can go wrong sometimes. Let's find some hip-hop stuff then, in general. And it still goes wrong. All right, sounds like Tidal doesn't like Safari at the moment. You see it, folks, this is live, so bear with me. We get this fixed or not, never know. Do I have some tracks here that I think, all right. Mr. Dabalina, why not? And there we are. And let's add that one track. Add to the playlist, AMA playlist. Why not? Talking all that jazz can be added to, add to the playlist. And what else do we have here? The OG Gangster, why not? This is typically my jam, folks, so bear with me. And if I go to my own playlist right now, right here, then we see we got four tracks in it. All done. Now the beauty of this. The moment I go to Recordbox, we have access to that playlist I just created. So I don't have to search again. And you saw how problematic searching can be. So if we go right here to the Tidal tab, and we go to My Collection, and we go to the playlist. There you have the AMA playlist in Tidal, and there you see the tracks we just added to that playlist. And the moment you load it up, it will be downloaded from Tidal. And there we are. Now there is one very important thing about especially Tidal, but this also goes for the other streaming services, and that is playback quality. And within Recordbox, you find that playback quality under Advanced right there, and then to Others right there. And there you see I've got lossless FLAC playback quality. Now let me show you what happens if you are going to mess with that playback quality while you have set it. So I have a FLAC track right here. I'm looking at FLAC. And let me set a cue point right here. Hard to miss, perfectly set. Let's put one on the snare as well. Not a snare, but it looks like a snare, so that's fine. So I've set two cue points here. Now let me switch, let me first quit Recordbox, then get back to it. Switch the audio quality and pull up that exact same track. Because if you haven't seen this kind of stuff, then you won't believe me. And if you don't believe me, well, then we get problems. So let me show that to you guys. Here we are again. Let's open the Tidal tab. Let's go to My Collection, to the playlists, right there. The AMA playlist. And let's first switch the quality. Let's say you are on a beach and you don't have the best connection, so you want to have just high instead of FLAC quality to make loading a little bit quicker. Or maybe you forgot it and you are working in a different app and you have a different quality. Now let me load up that Mr. Bablina track again. And look what happened to those cues. They are shifted. They are shifted because I set them in a different sample rate. I set them in a different quality. Now let me bring up a second one and do the reverse, because then you understand why it is so crucial, because you are creating a mess for yourself if you are constantly going back and forth different audio qualities. And by the way, this is not only for Tidal, this is for all the streaming services. So I set two cues here. Hard to miss, perfectly set. Quit record box. I have to quit record box in order to change it, otherwise it won't show you the changes. And I have to wait for record box to quit. There it is. Well, it is not really hard at all. It is pretty easy, actually. But the problem is that this phenomena we all know with static tracks as well. We know this problem the moment you use different encoders. I've got a complete tutorial about this, how that all works. But basically, you've got this shit in real audio files as well. Especially if you convert between different media. So this is nothing new, but I just want to show you. So now this one is shifted because I changed the audio quality again, and Mr. Dublina will be fine again because we went back to the original audio quality. You see? The takeaway from this is, please, 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 once you have set your audio quality, don't change it. And in order to avoid all those shifts, make the audio quality as high as possible. This is Tidal on FLAC, and I recommend Tidal on FLAC. We are going to beat port and beat source link in a moment. Both services work the same because basically they are both governed by beat port, so they work exactly the same, only the catalog is slightly different. They've got three different levels they offer you, but please, 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 don't switch those levels once you've set it. And I personally opt for the middle one in Beatport, and I opt for the highest one in Tidal. So this is for Tidal. Now, if I go to Serato, we have exactly those same tracks in that same playlist. And that is what I mean by you have the same tracks. By the way, as you can see, I am on the Serato Beta, and the Serato Beta for some reason has this annoying thing, paste not found, and usually after a reload it will show it, because there should be an enter and accept and a whole list of the shit they have changed. But that is with the Beta, but don't worry, we get there. I might have to force quit it even. We love Beta software, because there are some things in Serato DJ Pro I want to show you as well. So we are going to that later on. First, let's finish up the Tidal stuff. Then we go further with that. Oh, it's Witsy, the... and now I recognize you, buddy. You are the guy from Reddit with the shifting cues, etc. That's right. Welcome to the stream. So we have that, and I see that somehow everything is still connected. Let's activate my Tidal right here, and you find Tidal right there. And let's see, yes, I'm logged in, and you can see right here it's AAC, so that should be FLAC for the best results. And then you will see that playlist I just created, AMA playlist in Tidal, is there as well, with everything there. Of course, those tracks don't have cues yet. They don't have the cues from Recordbox. I've got a tool for that. I will show that on later, because right now I want to focus with you guys about all the stuff that is going on the moment you use streaming services, audio streaming services for DJs. And after that, I'm going to show you the real fun part where you can convert everything back and forth, etc. That's for later. This is for now. The next stop is, of course, beat source. Needless to say, that AMA playlist I just created. Oh shit, I forgot to switch my screens. Folks, this is one of my problems always. Sometimes I forget to switch screens. Then I'm so caught up in the moment and looking at my screen right in front of me that I'm not realizing, hey, he didn't switch his screen, so the guys don't have any idea what I'm talking about. Like this, because I should be doing this. So let me do that again. Let me do in Serato again what I just did, so you can see what's going on and you miss all the strange, weird feedback I got from Serato before. There we are. I should really take the server down, because that is the reason why there is a gazillion playlists there. Not going down, not going down. You see right here in Serato, under title, the AMA playlist. The settings for the quality are under library and display. There you can only pick one streaming service. That's a little bit of a thing I don't like about Serato and streaming service, but they will improve that later on. And you can see here the quality I just selected. So you can do that. And as you can see, this playlist has exactly those four tracks in it that we created in Recordbox. So those are basically the same. And when this is gone, I'm going to unmount my server, which will make loading and going back and forth a little bit faster. The same, by the way, if we go to the Denon Prime Gear, and while we are waiting for this, I can show you that. Why not? We have that stuff anyway. So here we've got an SC5000. I've just updated it to the 1.6 beta. Like I said, it's much like the other one. There we are. And if we go to Tidal, and we go to the playlists on Tidal, my playlists. Why don't you take... Oh, what? It doesn't show the playlist. There we are, playlist. No playlist found. Why not? Doesn't show the playlist at all, but it says it's on Tidal. Might be that it's on a wrong subscription, which would be odd, because I only have one subscription. Let's see my playlists. Oh, it's not showing anything at all. That's weird. Let me double check that indeed I am on Tidal. No. Simply is not showing any playlist. Again, this might be an issue with being on the wrong account on the player, so don't blame the player just yet. Maybe we do that later. Why not? At least I can go to Orange DJ. There I can eject. That will make Serato go much quicker. And in DJ we go to the title stream. There. And there you've got our playlist with, again, our four tracks. So it works pretty well to make that playlist in one central place, even if it's a little bit of a struggle. And once it's set up, that playlist, then you can just use it in all the software you have, even on the Denon Prime player, even if it lets me down at this moment. Next up is beat source and beat port. I will take beat port as my example. So let's go to that. Here we are in Beatport, and we already joined the club. Thank you. See if I'm logged in. I'm not logged in. Then I go to BeatSource, because that should have an account right there. Yeah, that's logged in. This is the BeatSource link thing, and right here you see this little thingy. That is where you create the BeatSource playlists, and that is exactly the reason why I wanted to show you guys this. It is deemed beta at the moment by the guys from Beatport, so they are working on improving it, and they better do it, because right now it is not exactly the most user-friendly experience ever. And I'm wondering why it is taking so long in loading it up. Looks like everything is against me today. Let me refresh this. Not this kind of odd playlist. Not? That should be fine. Why not? All right, let me off screen. Just see if I log out and log in again, if that will fix it. Usually that is the fix for everything, as you all know. And otherwise I will just clean out the caches. You have successfully logged in. There we are. That did it. Logging in, logging out, fixed it as usual. I already made a test playlist right there. I can create a new one. Let's call it new test play for AMA. And then if you say edit playlist, that thing changes to add tracks. So you have to be very aware of what you are doing, because otherwise it's very easy to lose track. And here comes the strange part about Beatport. It's not easy to find tracks in it. It really isn't. We spoke about Lean On by Major Lazer. They've got a shitload of Lean Ons, as you can see. But if you want to put Major Lazer in it as well, then it just expands the query. So you get everything with Major in it and with Lazer in it. So this is due for a very big overhaul to make it more usable, because right now this is not the most usable function, as you can see, that you can imagine. Let's take Believer. If you click this little thingy there, then you select it, and that means it's selected to be added to the playlist you just left. And here you also see what I meant. You've got Believer right here, you've got Believer right there, you've got an extended mix right there. So if you don't have playlists and you do this during your set, you never are sure which track is going to be loaded and does it have the cues or doesn't it have the cues. So that is always kind of a problem. And that's the reason why I say, please do this in advance to using the tracks, so you know at least that those tracks in that playlist are the tracks you have prepared, you have cues and loops for. If not, then it will be a problem. Why is that not added? Like I said, it is due for some. Let's add that one. Let's add that one. Oh, I didn't click the add. All right, that's my bad. Not much they can do about it. Click the add right there. Now we can see there are three tracks right there in that particular playlist. I can quit Safari here, and then we go to first record box, because Beatport, and like I said, and let me show that first before we go there, because I'm doing a gazillion things at the time at the moment. Where is my Safari? There it is. Just hide record box for a moment. Let's go to Beatport. Beat source, we are actually on, why not? There we are. And if you look at the subscriptions, I'm currently on the Link Pro, the $20 a month subscription. This is the subscription you want to have. There are others. You've got the Link, but that Link only got 128 KBS AAC files. All those streaming services use AAC because that's more optimized for streaming. That's AAC is Apple Audio Compression, which is basically MP3 for from Apple. That's how it reads. But AAC is optimized for streaming, and that makes it a little bit easier. And the obvious choice why to do. Don't take that one. I know it's just $10, but the quality is not good enough. And like I said before, the moment you set preparations in that $10 a month subscription, and you decide that you want better quality because the clubs are open and you want to use those tracks in real sets, and you have to set those cues and loops again because they will shift, as I just have shown you. If you take this one, that's the 256 KBS AAC. Now I hear you think, hey, Mixmaster D, 256 KBS, isn't 320 the norm? 320 is the norm for MP3s. 256 is a better sound quality, a better audio quality than you get from a 320 MP3. So basically, it's a little bit above MP3 quality-wise. And as you can see, the only difference between this one and that one, besides 10 bucks, is that this one has 100 tracks offline, and I get to that offline part in a moment, and this one get 50 tracks offline. Offline means that even if you are not connected to the internet, you are capable of using those tracks because those are in a special locker inside your DJ software, so-called BeatSort locker. All right, having covered that, here we are in Record Box, and let's go to the beat source there. And if we go to the My Playlist, then we see right here that the new test playlist for AMA is there, but it doesn't have any tracks. This one has tracks and that one doesn't have tracks. So maybe we should refresh this for a moment. Let's see if that fixes it. And otherwise we need to go back to the drawing board and see why that one doesn't have any tracks, because as we saw before, it has tracks. And I always like a good mystery, so that's why I go back and forth with this kind of stuff, just to find out why it's not working, why it is working. You never know. Let's find out. No, it says zero tracks. All right. Then we're going to fill it up for the third time again. Like I warned you guys, this stuff can use some... can use some improvement. Again, BeatPort and BeatSource deem it beta, so better treat it like that. It's a beta, why not? Add the tracks. All the tracks. And I stick to the same one, then at least I know what we are looking at. And I wanted to have that one. I wanted to have an extended one. And I wanted to have, why not? Let's take the naughty grind, why not? And we add that to our playlist. That's the thing. I didn't click save. Last time I didn't click save again. User error, but with everything going on your screen, that can be the case. So that's the reason why. Now we got three tracks in the new tested AMA. So let's go for Record Box again there. And always hydrate in time. And if we go to the beat source part right here, and then we go to the playlist. So these are, I will dive into that later on. Those are the playlists from beat source itself. Here we've got our new playlist, and you can see the tracks are there. Now I told you about the offline locker, and you see it right there. And right now there are zero tracks in the offline locker. One of the nice things of Record Box is that you can make your own Record Box playlists, and those playlists can contain tracks from BeatSource and BeatPort. You cannot do this in Virtual DJ, or actually you can do this in Virtual DJ. You cannot do this in Serato, you cannot do this in Algorithm DJ, and you cannot do this in Engine Prime. Only Virtual DJ and Record Box has this functionality, and it is pretty nice. So let's go right here and create a new playlist, and we call this Native Playlist. And the fun part begins here. I told you there are already made playlists right there. For instance, Top Tracks is basically the most popular tracks on the streaming service, and you can see some stuff showing up here. Everybody's going crazy for Show Me Love for the gazillionth time in my life, and you can take that Show Me Love track and you can put it into the native playlist. So now it is in an BeatPort playlist, as you can see, and you can load it up and it will all work, all very nice. Now, in order to get tracks in that offline locker, and that offline locker is right here, you have to put it there. You cannot drag this into it. You see, there is a forbidden sign. I cannot drag it into it. The only way to get tracks in your offline locker is if you go in the BeatSource part, so in one of those lists, right click the track and then say store offline right there, almost at the end of the pull down menu. Then it will put it in the locker, and there you see it in the locker. If you do this from native playlist, you see there is no offline locker there. So I was searching the full morning, where is this offline locker everybody talks about? It is not there. No, that's right, it is not there, because you need to do it from the bit source tab within the navigation tree, or otherwise it will not work. So that's nice as well. Then we've got the bit source playlists, and if you are into dance, you can just open the playlist there. And for instance, this is the Mojax playlist. And again, if you want to, and you want to have a track from the Mojax playlist, you can just add it to the store offline, and it will be put into the bit source locker. Now, this bit source locker is all fine and nice for everybody. However, there's always a big but. It only works for Rekordbox here, because if I go to Serato, and that's the reason why I've got the Serato beta on, because that's the first time that the Beatport and BeatSource lockers are supported. Oh, please. Can we get that off? And I need to switch, of course, to BeatSource as our service. And then I have to log in. That's okay. And there we are with the new test for the AMA. There we are. And there you can see the BeatSource locker already. And if we click it, it's empty. And there are two tracks in it, but those two tracks are in Rekordbox. Those are not the two tracks right here. So right now, we can put it right into it. And then we've got it. Good question, Candy. Right now, Engine Prime doesn't work with streaming services at all. Period. However, the Denon gear, like this little thing over here, does work with streaming services. So let me show that to you guys. Why not? We are working on it anyway. And then, always have to forget, or always have to remember that I switch it back. Right, that one. Let's wait for Serato to end. Serato. And let's close this one out. If you go to Engine Prime, you will not find, and this is the new one, this is the 1.6, as you can see, the brand new, shiny, all new Engine Prime. And if you go to the preferences, you see library, there is no streaming services to be found. So Engine Prime doesn't have it. That is the reason why I very particularly speak about Denon Prime gear if it comes to streaming services. And yes, they support it, because if we go over here and if I click source, and if I go to the beat source, because we just prepared that one, why not? And we go to the playlists. There you see the, and that is the one we just created, as you can see. And I can just load it up, and it will load it up like that. And while we are at it, why not? We can give that cue there. Let's give it cue there. And let's make an auto loop. This looks like something that we can loop with. Always have to be readable. All right, so I've got that all set. So what I did is the Believer original mix got two cues, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, and one loop. Let's change the view to the extended mix. And the reason why I do that is because I wanted to show you guys something. Namely, an app I've developed, which is brand new, and that is called the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming. And what the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming does is it will take the information that is on this drive, because if you use streaming services on a Denon Prime gear, you always need a drive to store it on. You can even use an empty drive if you want to. You can use an empty USB, but that gear needs a USB to store the cues and loops on. It will even not go to a streaming service if it's not connected. Let me show you that as well. If we now say source beat source, and let's see if we can switch something. No, once connected, it will do that. It will just not store everything that is done. So that's not bad. That's an improvement over the beta. Right here, we've got the drive with everything on it. Let me hook it up. And as we know, we have that track, the believer track, in both Serato, and because it is part of a playlist we use everywhere. I'm wondering why my drive is not showing up, but that it's already there. All right, I fire up the DJ conversion utility streaming. Let me show you how this stuff works, because this is fun, folks. This is the new app. It will go on sale most likely this week. We were from BeatSource, and the quality we used were high. We go from an Engine Prime, and we want to go to Recordbox, to Serato, to Virtual DJ. And Algorithms DJ is a thing in its own, because before I can convert to Algorithms DJ, a track needs to be loaded by Algorithms DJ, and you just saw me making that playlist. So that major laser track is not an Algorithms DJ. It will not receive any cues. And you can see that selects Untitled as the source drive. So we can wait. This is very quick. It will only take a few seconds. And then, of course, we get a bug. Why do we get a bug? Let me make a screen cut of that, because... Where is that? That's weird. It says there is a bug there. Back to the drawing board, I guess. Why does this always happen when I'm... when I'm doing this shit on a live stream? I'll look into that later. At least I got the screen cut about what it was complaining about. But most likely this will not fly then. Let me give just... No, not that one. I can make, of course, an empty playlist there and see what happens. But no, let's leave it for now. Let me give some other time to have a look at it, why it's not doing what it's supposed to be doing. But that is the thing with beta software. It can do weird shit sometimes. No idea why. I've been testing this stuff all day long. Okay, then we have covered the offline. We have covered the online support. We have covered that Virtual DJ and Recordbox can do native playlists with tracks from streaming services, which was also on my list to do. And I wanted to do the DJ conversion utility streaming demo, but that is complaining. What I can do is just make the drive empty, because then it should just fly fine. So let me double check that right now. Let me just empty this one. And then do again what I just did. Just take a track and just put some cues and loops on it. Why not? Write that one. And of course it shouldn't be crashing at all, but hey, shit happens. And this is all live, so we don't cut and we don't do anything else with it. We just show you that indeed it crashed. Let me find that one. Then we've got the naughty right here. Source is that, and then the source is BeatSource. And then we change the view and we take the believer track, which will lose it, will have lost its cues and loops, because basically we took it out. So we set the cue there, and we set the cue there, and then we set a short outro loop there. That's all fine. Then we go to the next track. And I do this just to make sure that the information is stored on the drive. So it's just forcing the drive to be updated. What I might have done wrong is that I yanked out the drive while it was writing down this information. So might have done that wrong. Right, let's eject it. And then you get that source drive not available message. Like I said, it requires a drive available just for the fun of it. And then let's see if I can force my camera to move. Sometimes the things don't always function quite the way you want it to function. Right, this should be it. Let's see what happens if I try it now, and otherwise it's back to the drawing board, and we leave that for a next time. from the bit source link, and we come from engine prime, and we come from the untitled drive, and we want to go all the way to this. And we still get that same error. At least it's consistent, and I like consistent errors because that means I can fix this. Very honest, I haven't tried this with the final release, so there might be something strange going on with the final release. I'll find out. This will be fixed, of course, before the stuff is released at all. Then what else is on my list? I've got pretty much covered everything I wanted to talk with you guys about audio stream, which means we've got time to answer questions, if any, in the chat. So if you've got questions, throw them in the chat and I'm happy to address them. Let me see what Robbie Diesel was talking, downloaded songs and added mix to get the cue points and production. I don't know. Robbie, are you still on? Are you still with us? Because this is basically what you're asking, is how does REC work? And there are tutorials in my YouTube channel that explain you step by step how REC works. If a track doesn't show the cues from mixed in key, you always have to be sure that you import it. You have to be wary of the record box XML import bug. That is the bug that prevents information from being updated in a record box collection. If the track is already in a record box collection, you can circumvent it, but it just requires a special way of importing. I don't see Robbie reacting in the chat, so I think he's not with us anymore. That means I'm not going to address that because the tutorials are there, and if the problem continues, then I'm happy to help you by either email or Facebook Messenger, whatever works for you. Any other questions you guys might have? What we can do, of course, because that should work just fine, is go back to Serato. See what's happening there. And just set some cues in Serato and then convert that stuff to the rest, because that should work for us. So here we've got the track again. Starting to know that track a little bit. I didn't know it before, so that's always fun. And we just set a cue there, and we give it another cue there, and we give it an outro loop. Why not? Right there, and we make that an 8 outro loop. And just to make sure that we know that where it is coming from, I named the first cue Serato. So there is no thing about, no question about where it's coming from. Yeah, I will address that in a moment, Candyman. Just hold on, buddy. Let me go to my main screen. Where's my main screen today? There it is. And just start up the DJ conversion to streaming. And I can still, oh, that drive is also there. Why not? You can write to it as well. Let's see what's happening. I'm very curious about what's happening now, because I think there is just incompatibility with the new firmware that Denon released. And if that's the case, then I've got some stuff to fix. We're all flying fine. You can see it are 11 tracks. Basically, there was already some stuff in the Serato collection. I could have used some very nifty selection method, and I will show that in a moment. But first, let me show you what has happened. And we can do that right here. Because we have native playlists in Recordbox, the DJ conversion to streaming will create native playlists. And you see, it has tracks that were updated and it has tracks added. Those tracks were added to the record box collection. They weren't there prior to our little playing. So that's the good part, because we have those native playlists. And there you see everything that was set there, everything I set in Serato. The same thing if we go to Virtual DJ. Then this is exactly, you can see right now why I press so hard on everybody using. That is not taking, it should be the original mix, I guess. There we are. There's the loop. Loop is near the end. And this is the loop active in Virtual DJ. And if we go to the cues, then we've got the hot cues there as well. So you can see everything is there converted to Virtual DJ as well. Overness DJ is not converted. And finally, I can show you that this should have worked. This should work on the Denon gear as well. Let me eject the drive there. At least you know that this shit works. Always nice to know, right? Let me switch the cams, but my remote switching is fighting me right now, so I have to do that manually. Walking over there. Here we are. Enabling the drive by the source. Then we go to beat source. Then I load the first one, because that should have the Serato cue now. And it doesn't. Why doesn't that load up? Let's find out what's going on there. That isn't the one. Was it in the extended? Where did I set my hot cues? Those cues were already there. And for some reason it didn't take the Serato cues either. So that's an indication that something is seriously different in the 1.6 final software. That needs to be investigated, because it doesn't refer to it. That's very weird. Even the artwork looks different now, because I had a different artwork, if I'm not mistaken, with the other one. Anyway, Candy's question. The main backup is incompatible with Engine Prime hardware. That goes back to something very old within Engine Prime. And let me show you what that means and how that works. Basically, Engine Prime can only work with two kind of hard drives, and those are FAT formatted and XFAT formatted. However, if a drive is an internal drive, and an internal drive is, for instance, this storage drive right there, that means it is a non-ejectable drive. We call that a non-ejectable drive. It's just a physical drive inside my computer. Then it can be an XFAT for a drive. However, if the drive is removable, and let me find a USB to demonstrate this. There we got the USB. All right. Got a USB right here. Let's format it XFAT. Or let's format it wrong. Let's format it the way that Denon doesn't like. Let's make it a macOS extended one. Brace. And we in macOS extended, and we leave it guide. Test. Yeah, the trick word here, Kenny MC, is external, because the drive I'm just formatting is, of course, a removable drive. It is an external removable drive. It's ejectable. It's got this eject button there. And if you look at what it looks like and why it's not showing, it's still working. Let it work. Yeah, exactly what I did right now. macOS extended formatted, and it's named test. If you don't know what your drive is formatted in, go to the disk utility, click it, press Command I, and then you can see right here, it's a macOS extended journaled drive. Now, the moment I put some tracks on it, let's put some tracks on it, why not? Take that away. That is all garbage tracks. Could have demo tracks, right? Demo tracks, right? Just move them to the wrong one. Yep. Going too fast for the computer even. All right. I got some test tracks on it. The moment I fire up Engine Prime will start to complain about this particular drive because this drive will not work with it. You can see that this is incompatible because it's not FAT or XFAT. That is because it's a removable drive, because the other drive I have, and that is the storage drive, let's use it, the storage drive as an example here, which is a physical internal drive, which is non-ejectable, which looks like this. This is the one I'm talking about, which is also XFAT formatted. And let's give it some test tracks. And that will work fine in Engine Prime. Let me eject this one. Let me start up Engine Prime. So this is one of the annoying things of Denon Prime, that if a drive is ejectable, then it needs to be formatted FAT or XFAT. Let's drop the tracks there. You see, it takes them fine. It tells you that they are on storage, and that storage drive is still journaled, HFS extended, macOS extended. So that's the difference. The difference is ejectable drives. Drives that are ejectable need to be FAT or XFAT in order to work with Engine Prime. If they are not FAT or XFAT, then they will not work with Engine Prime. Period. I hope that answered your question. And indeed, you need to reformat it FAT or XFAT, and then you can simply carbon copy clone or just copy everything one-on-one to the new formatted drive, and then it will work fine. That's the way you need to do it. Any other questions I can help you guys with? If not, then I've got a lot of work ahead of me, because something that worked very fine in the beta is not working anymore in the final version of the Denon Prime firmware. So that needs to be fixed, and that means I've got some work to do. Yeah, I know that those error messages can come out of the blue. Basically, it didn't work at all. However, not even in 1.5, I can double check that, but 1.5 didn't take that either. Or do I still have Engine Prime? No, I don't have Engine Prime. It would give you that same error message. What sometimes can be the case, especially if you're on Mojave or Catalina. Oh, hold on. What your problem is, if you were the one that you were upgraded to Big Sur, right? Or you were upgraded to a different OS. Sometimes the Mac OS will report removable drives as fixed drives. So this is a fixed drive. And how do I tell that? There we are. And it should say right there, it's on PCI Express. And let's see if it says, I think it's removable, bootable. Well, removable should be one of the properties right in that list. But some OSs misrepresent that and will say to the application above that a drive is fixed while it is removable. And like I said to you, the problem starts with removable drives. So the new OS most likely will correctly identify your external drive as a removable drive. This is where all the shit starts to happen, because at that particular time, as soon as Engine Prime sees, all right, a drive is removable and it's not FAT or XFAT, then you get that famous error message and then all bets are off. So you really need to bring in another drive, format that other drive, master boot record, MBR, XFAT or FAT, and then copy everything over to that new drive. Then you will be fine. Then it will work fine. All the data is there. Nothing is lost. You just need to make sure that on FAT or XFAT. It's annoying as hell, I know, but it's the way that Engine Prime works. I've been telling this to Denon DJ from the beginning of Engine Prime, because this was one of the first issues I encountered. All my tracks are on Apple Share file server, which is a removable external drive. And it was impossible to get tracks from that file server in Engine Prime. Which is also one of the reasons why I wrote my tools, because I couldn't work with the system. I love the players. The players are really great, but I couldn't work with them because I couldn't get my tracks on any media, or I couldn't do anything with them. So that's the reason why I did it like that. Any other questions you guys might have, I'm very happy to answer. And if not, we are calling it a night for tonight. Thank you for watching. Thank you for bearing with me. If you like what I'm doing, then please give this video the thumbs up and subscribe to my video channel, because I'm doing this every week. Usually I just accumulate questions I got from users of my tools over the week and then just answer them or show them again for everybody to share. So that issue maybe doesn't come back, maybe it does, you never know. Again, thank you for watching. For now, Mix Master G signing off.